Going back to work during the surge of the Delta variant hasn't been easy. Just ask a certain Vikings QB.
I've even thought about, should I just set up literally plexiglass around where I sit?
Sorry, Kirk, that's not how it works. Report after report in recent weeks have debunked the effectiveness of those now ubiquitous office dividers, even if your office is a locker room.
The dividers are sneeze guards.
Chris Hogan, a U of M professor of aerosol science, says dividers make sense at checkout counters and other places with brief face-to-face interactions, but not in offices where COVID aerosols have time to hang around.
A decent proxy for it is when we used to have smoking and non-smoking sections in restaurants. There'd be the occasional restaurant that would do this with a divider, right? And you'd say the smoking and non-smoking, and you knew that you could smell smoke in the non-smoking section if you were right next to it. We don't see a jet. What we actually see is the flow kind of going up and away.
So what does help? Cloth masks and distancing do wonders to control COVID at the source and during short interactions. But if you're working at a desk near other people for long periods, he says it's a good idea to come to work with questions about ventilation.
One of the things that you can ask about is the air changes per hour, sometimes just called the ACH, in the office space where you work. And this is the number of times per hour that the air in that space is kind of swept out and replaced. We often aim for around 4 in modern offices, more in bathrooms and higher in lunchrooms.
4 times an hour would be a good kind
of 4 or higher
baseline.
Yep. There's no such thing as too high here, so higher is better.
He says it's harder to ask about your building's air filters because their effectiveness depends on the amount of air your building system can push through, something he and his colleagues need an air tunnel to test.
Does this mimic maybe an HVAC system that you'd have at a workplace?
Yeah, that's right. This is designed to look at the technologies, we'll call it at scale.
And he says one technology has shown to be effective in all kinds of settings.
We did a study where we looked at what's called induct UV, that is UVC light inside a duct, and you would pass airflow through, and only 1 out of every 10,000 viruses that went in was still infectious at the outlet.
Though those UVC systems are now becoming more common.
This is a ducted UV unit, so there are UV bulbs in here.
They can be quite large and might be cost prohibitive for some. But if you don't have one in your office, he says it's okay. There are 2 very low-tech ways to immediately improve safety without lights or plexiglass.
How can we reduce occupancy to be half of what it originally was would be the first thing I would say. The other thing is when the weather is like it is right now, open the windows. You want that air change rate to go up. Open the windows, it goes way up. And we all know that because you feel it.
Now keep in mind, he says, by far the number one way to limit your exposure at the office is by limiting your exposure to the office. So work remotely if you can and when you can. And if you need to be there, try to, of course, limit close contact with others, like no closed meetings with no windows. All right, all of this is fairly obvious. We'll move on.